Maybe that's right. We talk about high humidity levels, and a lot of times we think that most, if not all, of that humidity comes from the south, as the humidity comes from the Gulf of Mexico and rushes into our area and really makes things really hot and humid. But there is another way that things can get quite humid, and it may not be what you think of. It's called corn sweat. That is actually the term, kind of the average person's term, but the science term, the geeky term, is corn transpiration. That is the natural way that the corn releases its moisture out of the atmosphere as it grows and produces the corn. Transpiration is simply when the water evaporates from the plant leaves. You'll see the water kind of settling on the corn leaves, and as air flows over it, that water evaporates and it becomes water vapor that goes back up into the atmosphere. Now, we'll use Ohio as a good example here. Ohio corn releases 10 billion gallons, that is not a typo, 10 billion gallons of water vapor into the air every day. And that can have a tremendous impact on the weather around it, as that moisture will then lead to increased humidity levels, which could then create higher heat index values. It never affects the actual air temperature, just how it feels outside. Well, look big picture here, and this is a USDA map of the most concentrated areas where corn is planted. Obviously, in the, you know, Corn Alley here in the northern Great Plains is where most of the corn is grown, especially in Iowa. But where you can get irrigation, especially along the Mississippi River, there's also quite a bit of corn that is grown, and that does include numerous counties, if not all counties, in the eastern part of the state that grows quite a bit of corn. In fact, I'll show you here in a second how much corn is actually grown in Arkansas. Now, 1 acre of corn can produce 4,000 gallons of water vapor into the atmosphere every day. And if we use Arkansas as an example, Arkansas has around this year 730,000 acres of corn. They produce just over 2.9 billion gallons of water vapor every day. And as that water vapor gets into the atmosphere, if you have the right winds, it can blow a lot of that extra humidity toward our area. And at times, according to the National Weather Service, corn sweat can actually add up to 10 degrees to the heat index. So it is a very real thing that affects your daily weather more than you may think that it does. So now you know all about corn sweat, and you can impress your friends. If you've got any other weather-related questions, you can certainly send them our way or tune in each Sunday around this time for some more weather knowledge.